Hello everyone, it is I, everyone's favorite jack of all trades with a foul mouth, coming to Urban. And we're going to jump right back into Angels of the Atlantic. So let's go ahead and get started. Chapter 16, Meeting Dr. Ballard. When the argument was broken up and resolved in a better fashion, Glenn went to the room of liners and turned on the TV and DVD player and was watching a National Geographic documentary on how the Titanic was found. When Glenn got into this and was busy watching, Titanic snuck in and stood behind him and was listening to what he was rambling on at the TV. "Well, Dr. Ballard, you may have found Titanic's resting place, but I have found her soul. And she is as beautiful of a woman as I've ever laid my eyes on." "Have you done that?" "No, I did not think so, sir." And he went back to watching the documentary when he heard the familiar soft Irish voice. "You really think so?" And then he jumps around and turns. "Well, Titanic, what were you doing here? I thought you'd be talking with Andrea Doria or Stockholm."
"No, besides they're busy talking with the others. Can I tell you something?"
"Well, yes, Titanic, go ahead. I'm all ears."
"Well, ever since I got to know you, every time I'm around you, I get this fluttery feeling inside my stomach, and I get all lightheaded as well, and I feel like I can almost float on air, and both of my sisters say it's love, and I don't know what it is really, and oh, forget it." And then she kisses Glenn right on the lips.
"Then," she says,
"I guess what I'm trying to say is, I love you, Glenn."
And then Glenn looks up at her, surprised. You love me?" Titanic smiles.
"Yes, I do. I don't know why, but I do. I just do. My heart sings out like a robin in the springtime."
Glenn's taken back by this. He's teary-eyed at this point. "Oh, come here," he says, as Titanic and him cuddle up in his recliner that he was sitting in. And from the crack in the door, Olympic and Britannic watched the whole thing.
"Oh, this is sweet. Our sister finally has someone that loves her," Olympic said. "I am so happy for her," Britannic said. Then they both started crying.
Titanic looked up at Glenn with her sparkling eyes as dark and blue as the ocean, and had said to him,
"I'm so glad you love me back."
And then Glenn says, "Well, ever since I heard of your story, I kind of was under the spell, and now I know why." Then the two of them finished watching the documentary, and then they drifted off to sleep. The next morning, Glenn and Titanic woke up to the sight of all of the other liner spirits looking at him.
"Oh, how romantic is this," Lusitania said. "Oh, it is such a sweet-looking couple," Empress of Ireland had added. Now, this is what I call a dream for most any lady," Aquitania replied.
Then Glenn got up, and Titanic did as well. "All right, ladies, it's all right. There's nothing to see." And then the phone rings. Glenn gets it. "Hello?"
"Yeah, Glenn, it's Jim."
"Oh, Jim, what are you doing?"
"I'm coming out to your place, and I brought a friend with me."
You are?
"Well, I guess I'll see when you get here."
Then he started to scramble to clean up the house. When he got done, he got dressed and went back down the stairs and heard the door ring. He answered it, and it was Jim.
"Glenn, it's so nice to see you again, buddy."
"Well, hi, Jim. What brings you back to my neck of the woods?"
"Well, I wanted you to meet someone. I wanted you to meet Dr. Robert D. Ballard."
Then a man with a hat that said Expedition Titanic came in, and Glenn was speechless.
You're Dr. Ballard, the man that found the Titanic and wrote the best-selling book Discovery the Titanic and Exploring the Titanic.
And then the man looked at Glenn and said, "And you must be Glenn Barker, the guy who wrote the best-selling book Secrets of the Titanic and Famous Liners of the 20th Century."
Yes, I am. Oh, it is such an honor to have you even here at my doorstep. You guys want to come in? Yeah, sure thing.
So Dr. Ballard and James Cameron came in.
I can't believe you know Dr. Ballard, Glenn said to Jim.
Hey, I know lots of people, Glenn,
Jim had said. Then Glenn, Jim, and Dr. Ballard started to talk about different shipwrecks. And when Titanic came up in the conversation, Jim had said to Glenn,
hey, introduce Robert to your friend.
That's a great idea, Jim,
I had said. Dr. Ballard, you said that ships have personalities like women, right?
Well, yes, I do remember saying something along those lines in a documentary once.
Why?
Dr. Ballard, I want you to meet someone. Come on out, Titanic. Then Titanic comes out, and Dr. Ballard's face was blank as she introduced herself.
Hello, sir. My name is Artemis Titanic. What is your name?
Then Robert tried to speak. My name is Dr. Robert D. Ballard. You can call me Bob, but you are the Artemis Titanic. The Titanic.
Yes, I am.
Wow, I can't believe it. The famous Titanic is a young, beautiful woman. This is so incredible. But Glenn, I want to know, how did you find her?
I had a piece of her hull, and it was glowing a faint gold. And as I was cleaning it off for some samples, and then it gold dust shot out of it and spun around the room. And when it cleared, what was left was Titanic right there.
Dr. Ballard was speechless.
Whoa. And I thought finding her resting place was a big accomplishment, but what you have found is a real accomplishment, Glenn. You know that, right?
Well, thank you, Dr. Ballard. That means a lot coming from you.
Just call me Bob.
Alright, Bob. I'm not done yet.
Then I called to the other ladies to the living room. They came and they made a line.
Bob, I want you to meet Olympic, Britannic, Lusitania, Mauritania, Aquitania, Carpathia, Empress of Ireland, Normandy, Andrea Doria, and Stockholm.
Then Bob's face really went blank.
And then he said, wow, now I can't believe this. You've got a whole group of famous ships in your house. I still cannot believe this at all. I must be dreaming.
Then Glenn spoke.
Then Jim spoke to Glenn.
Glenn, I don't remember Andrea Doria or Stockholm.
Well, just the other day after you had left, my friend gave me the bell from the Doria and a piece from the Stockholm, and that's how they came about in the first place. They tried to kill each other, but now they talked out their differences, and now they get along just fine with the others.
Wow, that's wonderful, Glenn. Just wonderful, James had said.
Then he went to see how Bob was doing.
Bob was drifting in conversation with all the ladies, just asking questions that he had wanted answers for.
Then I interrupted him. Hey, Bob, so what do you think?
Glenn, I don't know how you've done it, but this is like a dream for me. Talking to the Lost Liners themselves, it is a dream come true. An amazing dream at that, Bobby replied.
So, did you get to talk to Titanic and her sisters?
Yes, I did, and they are wonderful to talk to. Now I can really imagine what it must have been like during the height of their popularity and during their time.
So, is there anyone you haven't talked to yet?
I have talked to all of them, and they are all great company and very, very beautiful women.
Well, I am so glad you think so, Bob.
And then Bob got caught in conversation again and started to talk to Andrea Doria.
Then I went to my Lost Liner's room and Jim came in with me.
Glenn, I don't think I'll ever get Bob out of here now because of all those spirits of the famous ships.
I'm sorry, Jim.
No, it's not your fault, Glenn. It's just that Bob has explored the wrecks of these beautiful dames of the ocean and hasn't got a lot of his questions answered. Now he's got the spirits of these great ships face to face. And he's going to ask all the questions that he has conjured up, and he will want the answers to them.
Oh, Jim, how bad can it be? 4 hours later, Bob was still asking questions and was getting answers. Finally, when he was done, he came up to me and said, "Glenn, you are a lucky man and a very, very lucky historian. You have the group of the most famous liners in the entire world." Well, thank you, Bob. "Whoa, look at the time. We gotta get going," Jim said. "Yeah, oh God. Glenn, yeah, we need to be going," Dr. Ballard said. "Well, I don't want to keep you guys around, so I'll see you guys later. All right, Jim? All right, Bob? All right, we'll see you later, Daddy-O." "Yeah, see you later, Glenn," Dr. Ballard had said, and they left. Then I went to my lazy chair, and I sat down. And I turned on the TV, and the movie Titanic was on, and just started. So I started watching. Then Olympic told me something. "Whoa, that Dr. Ballard feller sure had a lot of questions. I know that for a fact." Then Titanic got into my lazy chair and cuddled up next to me. "Yeah, he had a bunch of questions for me too," and I thought, oh, he would never be finished. Then all the other liner spirits agreed that Dr. Ballard had a lot of questions. "What are you watching, Glenn?" Titanic had said in her soft Irish accent. "I'm watching the blockbuster movie Titanic." "You're watching the movie about me?" "Yes, I am." Then Titanic got comfortable, and as Glenn and Titanic was watching the movie that brought Titanic back to the people's interest, then all the other Atlantic angels came around and watched the film. And at the end, every one of them was crying, especially me, holding Titanic close by my side. Then I had drifted off to dreamland. But it already seemed like that, like a dream for me. An amazing dream it was. Thank you for listening. Until next time, this is Commodore Urban saying stay safe. God bless you. Take care. So long. Yeah.